Hello beautiful people, you're welcome back to my channel. My name is Lillian and this is Laura by Lillian fashion page on YouTube. In this tutorial we're learning how to make this illusion deep neckline. So now firstly we're going to get our pattern paper, and as always I'm going to fold this into two, leaving one part for my front and the other part for my back pattern. Now for this tutorial I'm teaching you how I drafted the front, which is the front that has the deep V-neck illusion, and it's also a basque corset. Is it basque? Okay, it's not really a basque corset, but it's a corset that has star lines. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and draw my imaginary line. Now I'm going to measure the length of my blouse. I'm using length 18 and then I'm using under bust 13, bust point 10, and the upper chest line 6. The upper chest line is like your off shoulder measurement. Now with my ruler I'm going to extend my lines. Now let's label it, guys. This is our upper chest line, this is my bust point, my under bust, and my waistline. Guys, if you haven't subscribed, please hit the subscribe button now. Now I'm going to go ahead and take my nipple to nipple measurement, which is 3.5. I'm going to take it all the way through and then I'll use my ruler to connect them. At the under bust, I'm going to take out 1 inch from both sides. You can take 1.5. It depends on how deep you want it to be and how big your breast is. And then at the upper chest line, I'm going to take out 1 from both sides, 1 inch from both sides. Now get your French curve or your whatever curve you're using. Use it to like give it the perfect curve, the perfect shape that you like. Okay, guys, make sure you're getting the perfect curve. Okay, so now this is what I have. Now coming to the bottom part, which is your waistline, remember I want to have a slanted style lines. So I'm going to go ahead and take out about 2.5 inches from the waistline. At one point I'm going to take out 2.5 inches and then I'm going to use my ruler to slant my line. And then at this other point, I'm not going to take out up to 2.5 inches. Rather, I'm going to take about 1.5 inch. You can still take out 2.5 if you want, but I wouldn't want to waste my paper that much. So I'm just going to take out 1.5. It will still give you the same, the exact, and even if you make it straight, even if you take out only 1 inch and make it straight, you will still get that style lines that you want. So guys, at this point we're going to go ahead and insert our measurements. Now I'm using bust 36, which is 9 inches. I'm using waist 30, which is 7.5. Then measure this, that spacing, which is 2.5 plus 1.5. Yeah, which is 4 inches. So I'm going to measure 7.5 plus 4 inches. And then I'm going to use my ruler to join it to my bust measurement. At this point, I'm going to impute my shoulder measurement minus 1 inch, which is 8 minus 1, which is 7 inches. And I'm going to go down by 2 inches. Now this will give me our armhole line. So now I'm going to curve my armhole. And I'm going to extend my line, my bust point line. Okay, now so if I was making an off shoulder, this is what I'll be having. And okay, I also want to make my corset a 3-part corset. So I'm going to, from that point, measure about 1.5 inches. That is the spacing I want. If you want a 2-inch spacing, you can get a 2-inch spacing. Then at the top part, I'm going to measure it and divide it into 2 equal parts. And I'm going to use my ruler, you know, to rule out a line. It could be straight or slanted. It depends on what you want. Now at the under bust, I'm going to take out 1/4 inch. That is 1/4 inch from both sides, making it 1/2 inch. And I'm going to connect them just as you connect your dart legs. Now this is my 1, my 2, and my 3. This is actually a 3-part corset. A straight corset, not a cupped corset. Now I'm going to go ahead and add my sewing allowance to my pattern. Now it's time for the illusion. At the waistline, I'm going to take out 1/4 inch. At the under bust line, I'm going to take out 1/2 inch. And I'm going to use my ruler to connect them. Now I'm going to get my French curve and curve into the upper chest line. As you can see me placing my French curve, place it in such a way that you get the perfect curve. Now this is the illusion. If I was making an off shoulder, this is what I'll be working with. But since I'm not making an off shoulder, I'm going to extend my pattern to the to have a shoulder and, you know, the sleeve and the neck and everything. So now remember I used 18 inches, so I'm going to go ahead and mark out my shoulder measurement. And then the next thing, I'll impute my shoulder measurement, which is 8 inches. And then I'll open my neck by 3 inches. 1 inch for my shoulder slanting, and then I'm going to slant it. So I'm using 5 inches for my neck opening. With my French curve, I'm going to draw my neck. And the next thing is to extend my armhole. Now I want to use an 8 inches armhole line. So that means I'm going to disregard the first armhole line and then I'm going to extend the line to 8 inches. The first one was 7 inches. 7 inches could work still, but I want to use an 8 inches line. So now I'm going to extend this. This is my new armhole line. Okay guys, so we're going to measure 7 inches and then connect our armhole all the way through to the shoulder. Now make sure you give this point a curve. It doesn't have to be pointed, and this is for our top illusion. So guys, this is what we have. We're going to go ahead now and then cut it. Our front pattern is ready. I hope you're enjoying this tutorial, guys. I really hope you're enjoying it. If you're enjoying it, please give this video a thumbs up, and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed yet. And if you're a returning viewer, thank you so much. I appreciate whenever I see new subscribers, I get gingered. I feel so happy, and I get motivated to like shoot new videos and post them. So it's really not easy for small YouTubers like us, beginning YouTubers like us. So if you support us with your subscribe, your views, your likes and comments, then we'll be motivated to do more and to grow. So guys, this is all the patterns we have here. This is it. Now we're going to go ahead and cut them on fabric. So these are all the patterns cut on fabric. I cut them leaving 1/2 inch allowance all the way around. I cut 4 pieces of each, 2 for the main fabric and 2 for the lining. But if you're using different pieces for the fabric and the lining, then you have to cut 2 for the main fabric and 2 for the lining. So the next thing I'm going to do is to iron my interfacing on my fabrics. And for this interfacing, I'm going to be using a haste. Now this is what my pieces looks like after I've ironed my interfacing on it. Yeah, it looks like a lot, but I'm going to join all these things together. So this is what it looks like. Now the next thing is to join them together, you know, join them and sew. Now this is what, yeah, it's like you're going to get your pattern 1, pattern 2 and 3. And this is the way you're going to join them. And then the next thing, you're going to get your 4. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You're going to join them together, you know, place one on top of the other and run your stitch. Open it up, place 3 on top of 2, and so place 4 on top of 3, and place 5 on top of 4, and so. So this is how you're going to join them all together. So for the illusion, I'm using this net. So as you can see, I'm stretching it to see the part that stretches. So remember, the part that stretches has to be your width, while the non-stretchy part has to be your length. So now I'm folding my net fabric into 2. And then I'm going to place my pattern on top of it and cut it using 1/2 inch allowance, leaving 1/2 inch allowance all through. Now, if this net fabric was lightweight, I would have folded into 4 so that I'll get 2 pieces, and then I'll join the 2 pieces together. But because the net fabric has weight, I don't really need to join it together to double it. What I'm going to do rather is to cut 1 and then use bias to fold the rough edge, like the neck. So now you're going to go ahead and cut out your illusion. your illusion mesh. Cut out leaving 1/2 inch allowance all through. This net fabric is actually not very stretchy. Yeah, but anyway, we're going to work with it. It's going to give us the results that we want. Yeah, so guys, do your cutting, make sure your hands are nice and steady. So guys, this is what it looks like. We're going to open it up, and then after sewing, after joining our pieces, we're going to join this to our front patterns, the left and the right side, and this is what it's going to look like. Yeah, I know I'm not showing you guys the full tutorial, but I hope you all understand what I tried to teach you. Now this one dedicated to the girl with the angel face and the devil heart. You know, Sir Ragamuffin, check out the most new top players come feel the case. Step up my youth, hear this. I know this little girl, her name is Maxine. Her beauty's like a bunch of roses. If I ever tell you about Maxine, you'll only say I don't know what I know. But murder, she wrote.